Sunglasses, she looks great in anything. She's, I want a piece of chocolate, take me to a movie. She's, I can't find a thing to wear, now and then she's moody. She's a Saturn with a sunroof, with a brown hair and glow. She's a soft place to land, good feeling though. She's a warm conversation that I wouldn't miss for nothing. She's a fighter when she's mad, and she's a love her when she's loving, and she's everything I ever wanted, everything I need. When I talk about her, I go on and on and on. Cause she's everything. Cause it's Monday. She's a bubble bath and candles. Baby, come and kiss me. She's in one glass of wine, and she's feeling kind of tipsy. She's the giver I wish I could be, stealer of the covers. She's a picture in my wall, my unborn children's mother.
This glorious evening, we have come to celebrate the marriage of Adam and Joanna. It is one of life's richest surprises when the faithful meeting of two individuals leads them to proceed together along a common path. It is indeed one of life's finest experiences when a chance relationship grows into a permanent bond of love. This meeting and this love are what bring us together today. The uniting of these two friends to establish a new family is an important and memorable event. It brings together two separate families and backgrounds and creates a union that is a sign of hope and joy for the future. In their love for each other, which they publicly express in this ceremony, Adam and Joanna demonstrate not only their joy in the present, but their commitment to share the future together. This is a time of celebration for all of you who know and love them. And now the bride and groom have honored me by asking me to deliver some lines that have a meaning for them from Paul to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not boast. Love is not proud. Love does not dishonor others. Love is not self-seeking. Love is not easily angered. Love keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. Love always protects. Love always trusts. Love always hopes. Love always perseveres. And love never fails. Adam and Joanna, may the promises you make this day live always in your hearts and in your home, so that all which you share now deepens and grows through the years, leading you through a lifetime of happiness. A wedding is more than the celebration of the love which lives in our brides and grooms' hearts today. It reaches into the future and proclaims their intentions for that which tomorrow shall hold. A couple who are joined not only by the mutual affection and love they share, but also by their hopes, dreams, and by the promises of what will be. The promises and vows they make this day shall guide them into their common future. I will ask you now if you are prepared to make those promises. Adam, please take Joanna's hand while you recite your vows.
Adam McLean, taking from Joanna, whose last name I still cannot pronounce or spell. I promise to love you and hug you every day, even on the grumpy ones. I promise to love and raise the three boys, Nathan, Cameron, and Navy, as if they were my own. I also promise to keep mini marshmallows in our house and race trailer at all times. Most of all, I promise my undying love and devotion to you. Ever since the first day we met at the race you stalked me at, but were still too shy to come over and talk to you. I knew then you were special. And then after meeting your two boys, I thought of just how special you were. You're a loving, caring, thoughtful mother. And you're a mixed perfect wife. Couldn't think of anybody more special than you.
And now, Joanna, if you could please keep on taking Adam's hand while you recite your vows.
Okay.
Take your time.
Adam, from the first message you sent me, was a simple hi. I don't know what it was, but I really had to reply, even though I was too shy to come say hi to you at that race. You still came over that night later. Ever since then, it's more than I could ever dream, even more than everything I could ever imagine. You have made our house a home and our family complete. I take you today as my best friend, my lover, and my soulmate. I vow to love you with all my heart, remember all the little things. I vow to grow old with you and fall in love with you more every day. I vow to be faithful, respect, and support you and be your biggest fan. I vow to wake up early for every race that we have. I vow to stay up late for every ride home that we have. I vow to be by your side no matter which path life brings us, unless it has a mud puddle, and then I'm not by your side. I vow you will be my everything, and I will be everything to you.
From the Egyptians came the custom of placing the wedding ring on the third finger of the left hand. They believed that from this finger, a vein of love went directly to the heart. Your rings that circle themselves are natural symbols of unending love. They have the bride's ring. Adam, please repeat these vows phrase by phrase after me. With this ring, I take you, Joanna, as my wife. I offer all that I am in return and pledge to remember over every day of our lives together why we unite here today. Joanna, please repeat these words, phrase by phrase, after me.
With this ring,
I take you, Adam.
I take you, Adam.
As my husband.
As my husband.
I offer all.
I offer all.
That I am in return.
That I am in return.
And pledge to remember.
And pledge to remember.
Over every day.
Over every day.
Of our lives together.
Of our lives together.
Why we unite here today. Adam and Joanna, today you are making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your lives with each other and honor your children as well. Your family relationship is symbolized through the pouring of the individual containers of sand, one representing you, Joanna, and all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. And you, Adam, all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. There are children who will share this marriage. Cameron, Nathan, and Aiden. Each child who will share in this marriage will also pour an individual container of sand. The gathering of this new family will have a deep influence upon them. We realize that in order for your home to be a happy one, it is essential there be love and understanding between the children and the adults being married. As you each hold your sand, the separate containers of sand represent your lives to this moment, individual and unique. As you now combine your sand together, your lives also join together as one family. And if the boys would join the happy couple at the table. You may now blend the sand together, symbolizing the uniting of the children and the bride and the groom into one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your marriage and family be. Now, Adam and Joanna have declared before all of us that they will live together in marriage. They have made special promises to each other. They have symbolized it by joining hands, taking vows, and exchanging rings. Thus, with the authority vested in me by the great state of New Hampshire, I do now pronounce you husband and wife. Sir, you may kiss your bride. Woo-hoo! The new Mr. and Mrs. to you for the first time, I wanted to direct your attention to the balcony behind you, where your photographer is waiting to take a picture of your newly united entire family. And we're going to take it on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three, smile! Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen. Mr. and Mrs. McLean.
Yeah.